Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Rachel and I'm a huge Eurovision fan as well as musician. In today's video, the time has come for me to react to San Marino's entry for this year's Eurovision Song Contest, Megara with 11:11 or 11th of November or 11 minutes 11 seconds. Can someone let me know? Or maybe I'll find out in the song. Let's see, it's not clear from the title. 11:11, let's just go with that. So Megara, I believe, competed in Benidorm Fest last year. It rings a bell, the name. Interested to see how this one sounds. San Marino is one of those hit and miss countries as well at Eurovision. They qualified in 2021 with a Senate and a Flo Rida, but then in 22 and 23 they failed to qualify because they really need to rely on that public vote, which is difficult for them to achieve in the semi-final. So let's see if they can turn their chances around this year. Stay tuned to the end. I'll score the song out of 10, give a bit of musical analysis and commentary as per usual, and consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. I make lots of Eurovision reaction videos from a musician's perspective. So without further ado, let's get straight into this. Okay, Spanish for San Marino, interesting. I'm just gonna stop it there. I don't know where I've stopped it, to be honest. I'm really lost, to be honest. I'm gonna try and talk about the music, but I think I was just very confused through that. I barely picked up on anything. I mean, there's a bit of a rock vibe, a sort of mid-2000s Disney chick punk rock sound, punk rock light, I guess, focusing mainly on a sort of punchy vocal. Lots of staccato notes in there, focusing primarily on the rhythms rather than the melody lines. I think I'm just a little bit lost because the melody lines seem to be jumping kind of from pillar to post here. And yeah, it felt like quite frantic. So I need to give this a little bit more time to sink in. And I'm not sure what the staging is all about with these sort of furry characters on stage. It's questionable looking. Let's carry on. It is giving like Selena Gomez 2008 vibes to me. That sort of Disney feel. Bit of Gwen Stefani, a little bit of that. Okie dokie. Interesting synth in there. Wait, what did she say? Sorry, I just need to hear that again. Oh, we love rock. Okay. Okay, a bit of Spanish guitar. I feel like that bit had a bit more soul to it, the Spanish guitar. Just a bit more authenticity, a bit more identity. Everything else seems to me to be very pastiche. It's like a synth-led rock song.
Mm.
I can't even nod my head to this, guys. Okay. I'm going to try and stay as objective as possible when talking about the music, but I will give my own opinion after this. The opinion is to come. Musically, like I said, it's giving Gwen Stefani, Selena Gomez, mid to early 2000s sort of punk rock light vibe with a bit of a synth in there to make the song a bit more poppy, I guess. And we've also got this kind of gritty female-led vocal with a lot of attitude in there. And we have these sort of electric guitars playing throughout, just providing a sort of a rhythmic quality to it rather than any kind of melody perspective. I'm gonna add my own opinion on now. I think this is atrocious. I'm so sorry. Oh dear, it's not for me, All respect to the artist, because I think she did give it her all, and you could tell that the crowd did like this. She enjoyed it and she was feeling what she was singing. And there was a sort of structure to the song and the stage performance and an idea there. It was not like a shambles. I just personally don't vibe with this at all. I can't find anything I liked about this. I'm so sorry. Just the way the guitars sounded in that track, they were tinny, they didn't sound real. Her vocal was turned down so low in the track, it was like when she was singing in her head voice in a sort of falsetto, you couldn't even really hear the notes she was singing. It disappeared in the track, and I think that would have been the most effective part of the song if the vocals were really at the front and center, because it was supposed to be gritty and female-led kind of rock feel, and it felt very subdued in the track. I felt like I was being overpowered by the guitars, the drums and the synths, and I really needed her coming to the forefront. I felt like the backing vocals could have been better, more harmonies, really pushing the vocal line right to the front of that track. It needed that desperately. Really severe lack of melody line that I could hook onto. I think genuinely because it was so low down in the track, it was hard to remember it. It wasn't standing out. But also genuinely, it just felt a little bit messy, a bit haphazard, notes falling all over the place. It didn't feel coherent. I really can't get behind this. I'm so sorry, because I feel like some people might really enjoy this. And it did have an attitude and a grit and a sass about it. But it just, for what it was, it could have been so much better. Think about What You're Waiting For by Gwen Stefani. That's the vibe they were going for. And think about how good that song is compared to this. They've just missed the mark, I think. They really have. It's such a shame. Oh, dear. I didn't like the costumes as well. I didn't understand how they fit into the song. But mind you, I didn't get the lyrics because I don't speak Spanish very well. So I couldn't really understand the meaning of the song in general. But I really just, I'm so sorry. I just can't get behind this at all. I really didn't enjoy that. But objectively, I'd say from, you know, musical perspective, there was some redeeming qualities in there. I think there was a general good pace to the song. I think that the drums and the guitars kept everything moving, but I just think the way they were mixed into the track and their general purpose maybe wasn't fulfilled to the best of their potential, perhaps. Yeah, I think also that kind of EDM dubsteppy feel, we kind of had that in Bambi Thug song as well. I felt that didn't quite fit into the track. I can tell exactly what they were trying to do. They were trying to beef out the song and add a little bit more of a metallic sound with that kind of dubstep feel to take the song and the sound of it into a different realm, not just a rock kind of sphere, but taking it into a rock and techno kind of sphere. They missed the mark because the sound design of that dubstep bit was so dated and clashed with the tinny guitars that it ended up just sounding really kind of amateur to me, to be completely blunt. So I'm going to give that a 3 out of 10. I can't score that any higher. To me, that was just not my cup of tea. But all respect to the artist, because I've heard her other stuff from Benidorm Fest and I did like it. I just think this song in particular, as the 3 minutes and as it stands, I just couldn't vibe with it, I'm sorry. But let me know down below in the comments what you think of this. And, you know, there's always going to be a song at Eurovision that I don't like, and I can't kind of sugarcoat my opinion. I have to just be honest. I feel like, you know, I can't just be positive 100% about every single song. I have to be honest, and that's how I feel. So there we go. I'm going to go now and have a really nice sweet cup of tea to sweeten the mood up again after that rant. But yeah, I'll see you guys soon, because tomorrow I'm going to be doing Croatia, which I know is the favourite to win currently as I'm filming this video, and I'm excited to see what they've done this year. It's very exciting if Croatia is the favourite to win, because they have not won before. So let's see how that one goes, and for the time being, I hope you have a good rest of the evening and stay tuned for more. Bye.